Today I want to go ahead and show you what I do on retouching my winter sunrise photographs, which you see right here. And I'm actually using the Lightroom CC Classic version here, is the one I'm going to show you on. Now real quick, on my settings I used. So the settings I used for shooting this photograph, I had my camera set up on a tripod and I had it set at 1/50th a second, aperture at 7.1, ISO 100. And I was using my 11x16mm f2.8 lens. And this was actually taken on a very cold January morning, January 2017. Temperatures were in sub-zero, and I wanted to capture the old historic mining cabins in Frisco, Colorado, with the morning sunrise coming up. And I kind of knew where the sun was going to be coming up at this time of year, so I kind of stationed everything into position here. And I was shooting in raw format, so any of you that have shot in raw format, you know that your pictures will come out really flat. And to show you the comparison, this is my raw photograph shot, but this is the colors I was able to bring back out in Lightroom. Okay, I strongly recommend you to shoot in raw, and the reason for shooting in raw, it does actually add a lot more information into the photograph for you to currently bring out in Lightroom or Photoshop. So let's go ahead and I want to show you the process I use for doing the retouch on this photograph. So I'm going to go ahead and hit reset. And this is the very beginning shot right here. So the first thing I'm going to do up here is the tint. I want to bring a little bit of the tint, and I'm going to bring this up to probably a plus. Let's go about a plus 33 on that one. I'm going to come down here where it says highlights, and I'm going to bring the highlights way down, and I'm actually going to bring the shadows way up. Now you're going to have this really flat look here. So at this point you want to take your whites. I'm using an Apple computer, so I think on your Windows computer you'd be hitting the control key, but I'm not positive. But on my Apple, I'm going to hold down the option key. And on the whites, I'm going to go ahead and click, and I'm going to bring it to the white until I start seeing it blowing out. And you should start seeing dots and stuff start to come out through the black there. Same thing on the blacks here. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to lower the blacks down. And I just want to bring a little bit into the picture here. So I'm about negative 44. And looking at it, I think I'm going to bump it up just a smidge. So clarity, vibrance, and saturation, I'm going to come back to that. So let's come on down and we're going to look for HSL color in black and white. So let's go ahead and click that tab and make sure you're under saturation. The idea here is I want to bring out the colors in this picture, and I have a lot more control by doing it manually here. So I'm going to just go ahead and just slowly start bumping up some of the reds, orange, and each one of these sliders, just kind of slowly bring them up and down to, and you're kind of watching the picture at the same time to hopefully kind of feel the colors. So pretty much all these I kind of slowly brought up a little bit. A lot of them are in the 20s to 30s here. So now down here under split toning, and then go under highlights, I'm going to bump this saturation up to probably about 7. And then I'm going to take the hue slider and I'm going to drag it across. And I'm trying to find a good spot where it looks pretty good there. So I'm going to kind of hold it about right there. So scrolling down under sharpening, I always like to sharpen my pictures up a little bit. So I'll take these up to about 50% or 55. And then under masking here, once again, I'm going to hold my option key down. And I think it's your control key on your Windows. So I'm holding my option key down. I'm going to click on masking and I'm going to bring the slider over. Basically anything in black is not getting sharpened. Okay, under noise reduction, I want to take the luminance up to probably about 15, since this photograph doesn't have a lot of noise in it. And then under lens correction tab here, if you click on that one, I want to do is enable profile correction, because I was using my wide angle, and as you see, it pops the picture out more flat there. Then under transform, I want to hit auto on this one. So as you can see, when I do hit auto, it actually kind of makes the building stand up more upright, and it definitely takes the fisheye out of the wide angle lens I was using there. Under effects here, if you just click the effects tab, We want to go under highlight priority, and I'm going to drop this down to probably about a -7. And then the last slider on the bottom here, I want to take the dehaze up to about 10 on that one. So now here's where the magic begins. So I'm going to come on back up here. Under clarity, I want to jump this up to about 7, 12. 12 looks pretty good. Vibrance, just going to bump that up to about 7. And then saturation, about 7. Now I want to take the graduated filter. I'm going to click on that. It's this icon right here. And under exposure, so what I'm going to do here, actually, I'm going to hold my option key down on my Mac, and I'm going to hit reset. Make sure everything's all fresh here. And I want to do is take the slider down a little bit because I want to darken up the sky because I feel like it's blown out. So once I get the settings good, I'm going to go ahead and just kind of click, drag down the graduated filter here, put it into position. I'm going to drop down the sky just a little bit more, and let's take the clarity up a little bit more. And once I'm done with that, let me hit done. Now the last thing I want to do, I want to go to the radial filter here. Once again, I'm going to hit my option, reset. I'm going to bring up my exposure a little bit here. Now what I want to do is I'm going to just draw a couple just real light circles here. And this is actually where the secret comes into making your pictures pop. And if you do it so subtle, a lot of people will never notice what you did there, but it looks so cool looking at the same time. So I'm just going to kind of light up some of the snowy features on these buildings. I'm just throwing a couple out there real quick, just to give you an idea for the feel of what I do here. And lighten up the windows too, definitely helps. And then with each circle here, you can always just go back and click on one, and then you can always adjust the exposure a little bit. And then the last thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to just make a real big one that kind of highlights the areas I just went with the circles. I'm going to bring down the exposure just a smidge. Maybe bump the clarity just a hair on that shot. And then hit done. So at this point, if this looks like something that would be good to you, then you would just hit file and then export the photo. So anyways, I just wanted to give you some quick tips on how I retouch my winter sunrise photographs here. I hope this helped you out and gave you some good ideas on how to work on your photographs there. Definitely subscribe if you haven't. Hit that like button if this helped you out, and we will catch you guys on the next video.